Hello, if you are a flat earther, please watch the whole of this video. At the end I will give you information about how you can check it for yourself in the real world. When arguing against flat earthers, a lot of people will show a video like this of a ship over the horizon partly hidden by the curvature of the earth. However, flat earthers say it's due to the waves and visual distortion. Well, to them I say ignore this ship and look carefully at what's around it. In several places on the horizon, you can see the rotating blades of wind turbines at the Galloper wind farm in the North Sea. These are around 29 nautical miles from the beach I'm standing on and are up to 180 meters tall. I went past them on a ferry in 2018 and took this photo. Let's take a closer look and concentrate on the one on the right. Now let's freeze and superimpose a cutout from the photo I just showed you. This is far from accurate, but gives you an idea of where the bottom would be if you could see it. The enormous distance between it and the horizon proves beyond any doubt the curvature of the Earth. You can't argue it's due to the waves or visual distortion because it's so large. In case flat earthers think this video is faked, they can check out everything I have said for themselves in the real world. They should travel to this small seaside town of Felixstowe in Suffolk, England. Find the only pier and look straight out to sea. If they are still unconvinced by what they see, they should then travel to nearby Harwich and board one of the Stena passenger ferries to Holland. Make sure it's a day journey so you can see the wind farm close up. Anyone else watching this video will probably wonder why I made it, because we all know the world is round. Flat earthers though claim that every reason we have for knowing it's round is fake. They think that thousands of people in power are working together to trick us, whether it's fake moon landings or the way GPS works. If someone believes everything is a lie, then it's hard to show them the truth. I'm very pleased though that I was able to do that in this video. And as I said previously, they can check every fact by going to Felixstowe themselves. You are welcome. Since my followers are puzzle fans, this part of the video is for them, though I decided to keep to the same theme. The puzzle I'm holding is a Hungarian globe made in the 80s. As you can see, it's a pretty good representation of the Earth. It has tiles that slide around the middle like a simplified V-sphere. The eight triangles are fixed though and cannot be scrambled. The other puzzle is a Rubik's World from 1982. It's a shape variation of a regular Rubik's Cube. Its colouring is quite poor and the map is so bad it's hard to see what should go where when scrambled. In some ways that's a good thing since it makes it harder to solve, though I still don't like it very much. You'd think the only puzzle suitable for an Earth-looking colour scheme would be spherical ones. However, if you go to Oliver Sticker's website, you will see some other shapes. He is selling the sticker sets, by the way, and not the puzzles. I will add a link to my description in case you are interested. I'm really surprised at how well they work, and perhaps the world's not a ball after all. Maybe it's another shape like a dodecahedron. Maybe I'll set up a dodecahedron Earth Society. What do you think? I'm pretty sure it would get more members than a flat earth one. Okay, so this video has wandered a long way from where it started. So time to say goodbye. And if any flat earthers are still watching, I am pleased that I could help.